Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing about cement and its composition. Cement, which is the most important material in the construction industry, which is formed by using different components. Now, what is the definition of cement? In exact word, as we discuss, cement is a powdery substance formed by calcinating limestone and clay, which binds aggregates together, sets and hardens. So cement, as you can say, it is a binding agent which binds aggregates together and it will set and harden, and it is formed by calcinating limestone and clay. In further slide, we'll discuss about the combinations of your cement. In cement, we require raw materials, which is lime. Lime is the main raw material in the formation of your cement, which is about 60 to 65%. Then next is silica, it plays 17 to 25%. Alumina, 3.5 to 9%. Iron oxide, 0.5 to 5%. Then we have magnesium oxide, which is about 0.5 to 4%, and sulfur trioxide, which is 1 to 2%, and last is alkalis, generally in the form of 0.5 to 1.3%. So from this we can see lime, silica and alumina plays very important role in the manufacturing of cement, and these are the main components of your cement. So lime take already 60 to 65%, silica 17 to 25%, and gypsum might be present in the amount of 0.2% only. Let us discuss about the four main compounds, that is also known as your Voges compound, and these are very important and their properties we should be understand before using the cement. The first compound is tricalcium silicate, which is also known as C3S. That is nothing but 3CaOSiO2. So remember, tricalcium silicate, C3S. Next is dicalcium silicate, that is C2S, and its chemical formula is 2CaOSiO2. Third is tricalcium aluminate, that is C3A, that is C3CaOAl2O3, and last is tetracalcium aluminoferrite, which is C4AF. These are the main four components of cement, which is C3S, C2S, C4A and C4AF. Now we'll discuss about effects of these compounds on cement properties. C3S and C2S are generally 70 to 80% of cement control most of the strength giving properties. So most of the strength giving properties are controlled by C3S and C2S. On hydration, C3S and C2S give same product, that is calcium silicate hydrate and calcium hydroxide. C3S is faster rate of reaction accompanied by faster or greater heat of evolution and develops early strength. So C3S is responsible for early strength. So we'll keep in mind, C3S is important for early strength. It means what? It will give higher rate of heat of hydration. C3S liberates nearly 3 times as much as calcium hydroxide on hydration as C2S. So C3S will give out 3 times more carbon dioxide or carbon hydroxide as compared to your C2S. Whereas C2S hardens slowly and provide much of the ultimate strength. as we know, C3S and C2S both plays the role of getting strength to the cement. So C3S will give you early strength and C2S is responsible for ultimate strength, that is your long strength. C2S is more resistant to chemical attack, whereas the C3A imparts flash set property to cement paste, immediate shifting of paste. So C3A is responsible for your flash set. It will set fast. It will not give you the strength, but it will set fast. It means what? Your concrete will get hardened fast, but it is not necessary. It will gain the strength also. Early strength will be given by your C3S. C3A weak resistant against sulfate attack. C3S has weak resistant against sulfate attack. And talking about the last component, that is C4AF, acts as a flux material and accelerate hydration of silicate. It will accelerate the hydration of your silicates. So C3A and C4AF hydrates rapidly, but its individual contribution to the overall strength of the cement is insignificant. In this video, we have discussed about cement, its composition, and the four important compounds which are useful in cement, that is C3S, C2S, C4F, and C4AF. Thank you.